your heart to me. Your weary souls in my bosom. To free you from your hate. Do not your souls weigh heavy? Your souls are stained. shall free you from your hate. To bliss. Your souls are stained. Your souls weigh heavy. To free you from your hate. Surrender to bliss. Your souls are stained. Why are you refusing to serve me?
You did it again. You saved them. I just wish I could have been more help. So, it looks like the Ananta did have a mountain of crystals after all. Like every other tribe. Gods were all such slaves to our weaknesses.
You slew our mistress! She was our hope, our salvation! Is there no end to your cruelty?
Listen to me, please. I know that you're only trying to protect yourselves because you feel frightened and alone. But that's how we all feel, don't you see? If we could just turn to each other for help instead of the gods, I'm sure we could find a way to live in peace. Your crystals are important to you, aren't they? Reflections of your souls, right? Well, you shouldn't have to sacrifice something so precious to a primal.
Who are you to question our choice? You who fight without fear? We wish only to live in peace. And if this be the price we must pay, then so be it!
I know there's nothing I can say to convince you. But I hope that one day you look back and see we only ever wanted the same thing.
Be gone, damn you! Spare me your hollow words, and leave me to mourn.
I'll go. But it doesn't mean I'm giving up. Girabania is our home too. And one way or another, we're going to have to learn to live together. Come on, Alfino and Alize are waiting.
Ah, the savage returns, and with her tail firmly between her legs, beaten by beastmen, I hear.
It was a shameful display, by all accounts. She may have curried the Viceroy's favor with her bold promises, but in the end, she's just another plodding bungler like the rest of her kind.
Strange. You would think him a better judge of character. Then again, I hear she's not averse to a more physical mode of persuasion.
I thought she rose through the ranks rather quickly, but no longer. If only she had been content with her lot, she might have lived to see the morrow.
Fadola Rem Lupus. Commander of the Crania Lupi, reporting as ordered.
Why do you tremble, sir? Could it be that the Empire's butcher is afraid? That she who walks with death is terrified of her own?
I'm terrified of dying, having achieved naught. Gladly would I give my life to win a great victory on the battlefield, had I but the strength.
Alas, you do not. Indeed, you are weak. And born of this weakness is a blind fervor, a raging inferno which threatens to consume not only you, but everyone around you.
Yes, my lord.
You were defeated by the Resistance on several occasions. You misjudged the Ananta and spurred them into summoning an Icon. Have you anything to say?
I do not, my lord. My failures are my own. I am prepared to accept your judgment.
And that is very admirable. However, I've had enough of this dumb show. Give voice to that hunger I see in your eyes, or I will pluck them from your head.
I want... I want to make them pay! All of them! Everyone! anyone who ever mocked or looked down on me! I want the power to make them pay!
Very well. Then I shall give you a chance. A chance to transcend your mortal limits. Assuming, that is, you are prepared to wager your life for such power.
Transcend, my lord. I came here prepared to die. Tell me what I must do.
I remember how they laughed. Alliance and Resistance soldiers, eager for battle, trading jokes as we marched east towards the peaks. Beyond this last line of defenses lay the locks and the city. Breaching it would be no small feat. But we beat the Imperials back, just like that. And we liberated a village, the first of many.
Let us see. So, she lives. Impressive. Or merely lucky, though that too may prove a useful trait.
My lord, what have you done to me?
Though we Garlings are intellectually and physiologically superior in almost all respects, we lack the hereditary traits required for the reliable manipulation of ether, hence our unique inability to wield magics. This deficiency, for want of a better word, saw us subjected to decades of oppression by the lesser races, and we were eventually driven to seek shelter in the cold northern reaches of Ilsebaard. Fortunately, said region was replete with vast deposits of ceruleum, which proved instrumental in the development of Magitech, a revolutionary technology conceived to compensate for our disadvantage. It was with Magitech that we grew strong, that our nation became an empire. Yet, ultimately, this was an extrinsic solution to an intrinsic problem. What I wanted was not a crude device to be used in lieu of magic. Through modification of the Garlean genome, I argued that it might be possible to enhance a subject's ability to manipulate ether, effectively empowering them to wield magics. Alas, my theories were met with consternation in the Imperial Court. Only Lord Xenos, with commendable foresight and wisdom, deigned to support my research.
You gave me this treatment, but I'm not Garlean.
Alamegan, through and through. What you have been granted is far greater than mere magic. Before that lesser light, it is as a second sun.
I am informed that Alighieri was recently occupied by the Resistance, and that an attack on Specular Imperatoris is considered imminent. This could provide an ideal opportunity to test her performance in the field.
Your skulls, was it? They have joined the garrison at the Watchtower?
Yes, my lord. By your leave, I would rendezvous with them and lead a counterattack against the insurgents.
No. Even were you to leave now, you would not arrive in time. There is another duty I would entrust to you.
Thank you. Come now, father. You lured the fool onto my blade, and do not try to deny it.
Our work here is all but done. What of Conrad and his men?
They are for the main tower. The Skulls have offered fierce resistance thus far, but Conrad seems to believe he can convince them to lay down their arms.
Then we will tend to the stragglers down below. With me!
Report. Enemy forces have overrun the lower facilities and appear to be mounting an assault on the main tower. We have already received a request for reinforcements. A unit of legionaries has been mustered and is ready to depart. They await your orders, Commander.
Stand down.
Commander?
Tell them to stand down.
Commander, if I may, our people... Your people are still in there. They will be slaughtered.
You think I don't know that? I want nothing more than to help them. To lead the bloody charge. But I have my orders. Lord Zeno said no reinforcements. He would have us use the main cannon to destroy the installation.
What? Kill our own soldiers? You must be mistaken.
Mayhap you'd like to ask Lord Zenos yourself. I thought not. Initiate the firing sequence. Wars are won on the backs of the dead. Theirs and ours. There is no truth but this. We must remain firm and resolute and always, always do our duty. Now, give the order.
Initiate firing sequence.
Aye, aye. Initiating firing sequence. Release safety locks. Deploy main cannon.
I need you to confirm the target, Commander.
Specula Imperatoris, main tower. Fire when ready.
Seven hells!
Long-range artillery!
Those treacherous bastards! Their people were still fighting! Full retreat! Now! Relay the orders!
Understood. All forces retreat! I repeat, all forces retreat!
Conrad! Conrad, speak to me!
It was all so sudden. Conrad had just convinced the last few Skulls to surrender when we heard the bang and everything started to shake. We carried the survivors to safety, but Conrad's... We have done what we can for him. All that remains is to pray.
Conrad?
Is that you, Lise? I can't see a damn thing. Well, that's that then. Time's up.
What are you talking about? You'll be on your feet before you know it.
It's all right, Lise. I've lived long enough. But listen, I want you to lead the resistance in my stead.
Don't say another word. You'll recover. We'll recover. We'll bring freedom to El Amigo together. We're not going to stop here.
No, you won't. Everything we've built, everyone we've brought together, I know you'll show them the way. You've got it in you, Lise. Not because you're Curtis's daughter or Ida's sister, but because... Because you're you. Because you're you.
Conrad.
Lead them to victory. To freedom.
I will, Conrad. I will. I promise.
Next round! Double the charge!
Come, Nidhogg. We are needed.
The Cerulean pipeline!
Impossible! How could one man? Shoot the bastard! Shoot him!
My lance has slain far greater beasts. You're welcome, boy.
Notify all units! I want that intruder found! And get the engineers to fix my bloody cannon! The savages are coming!